Hello and welcome to TI Precision Labs. In this series, we're going to cover the Peripheral Component Interface Express, or PCI Express. PCIe is a high-performance interconnect that leverages bandwidth, scalability, advanced error detection, and hot swap functionality. PCIe is commonly used throughout computing and storage platforms to interface with CPUs, GPUs, storage elements, and long-distance interfaces like Ethernet. In this first session, we'll talk about elements which make up the PCIe signal path, and the effects of attenuation on its primary transmission media, 85 ohm differential traces. Then, I'll show you how PCIe data encoding and packeting helps improve system performance. In future sessions, we'll go into more detail about the specific aspects of the PCIe physical layer, and how signal conditioning components can extend the solution space of this widely used interface. Listed in the table shown are several generations of the PCI Express standard. To keep up and stay relevant within the modern data center, PCIe activity has surged ahead over the past few years, increasing the data rate by 4 times from just a few years ago. Although the data rate in most PCIe connections has increased, the distance the signal must travel has not been reduced. In many cases, the distance has even increased. To leverage the benefits of a higher data rate, PCIe links since Gen 3 have utilized a more efficient data encoding to reduce overhead. The speed growth is so quick that systems are leveraging lower loss PCB material in order to support Gen 4 and Gen 5 signal requirements. From a device perspective, transmit and receive equalization specs expand with each generation of PCIe, allowing for reliable operation with only a small eye opening to recover the data. Only by combining recent device and material improvements can systems realize the full potential of the new PCIe specifications. Even with lower loss material and advanced device level equalization, the need for in-channel PCIe signal conditioning continues to grow. For the first time in PCIe, Gen 4 signal conditioning functions have been written directly into the base PCIe specification. There are two types of signal conditioning functions used in PCIe systems. One is a protocol-aware retimer, and the other is a protocol-agnostic linear repeater. The retimer is a relatively complex function fully embedded into the system protocol. On the other hand, a linear repeater lacks any protocol awareness. It simply uses analog equalization techniques to expand the eye opening and make the overall channel to the PCIe receiver appear to have a lower attenuation. Since PCIe 3.0 was standardized in 2010, higher speeds and increased system complexity have often resulted in channel architectures which struggle to comply with the maximum channel loss limits. As shown in the previous slide, system materials and devices have evolved to handle the increasing speed and attenuation present in PCIe links. The maximum channel loss in the PCIe standard has gone from a few dB in Gen 1 to over 35 dB in the upcoming Gen 5 specification. However, some channels still find the attenuation goes beyond the limit set by the PCIe specification. One method to combat the increasing attenuation is by using a relatively simple linear repeater or protocol-aware retimer. A repeater, or redriver, is an equalizer that provides a linear boost to high-frequency waveform components by using continuous time linear equalization, or CTLE. This offsets a portion of the overall channel losses. To help others understand linear equalization, I often use a simple human analogy. Audio equalizers are often used to help boost signal components which speakers have difficulty reproducing, or our ears have difficulty hearing. A similar issue is encountered when transporting electrical signals on a PCB or in a cable. As high-speed signals pass through the transmission media, the high-frequency signal components are quickly attenuated due to the physical properties of the conductor and the surrounding dielectric. This reduction in high-frequency components makes signal recovery more challenging at the PCIe receiver. A redriver's CTLE and linear drive functions work together to reconstruct and pass analog transmit waveform characteristics onto the system RX. This analog-only approach allows the system host and endpoint devices to communicate directly in a single link training process. Conversely, the retimer is firmly aligned with the PCI Express protocol. Leveraging a retimer to divide a long, complex, non-compliant PCIe channel into two parts creates a compliant upstream and downstream channel topology. The retimer participates directly in equalization training for both upstream and downstream directions and will allow both to independently optimize their equalization settings. This effectively doubles the maximum link attenuation of the standard. It accomplishes this feat by utilizing a clock and data recovery system, or CDR, which resets the jitter budget, and by performing adaptive equalization, meaning it automatically applies equalization based on the characteristics of the channel. If attenuation is too high for correction by a redriver, or the channel is too complex, a retimer is a perfect solution. Another difference between retimers and redrivers comes in the form of device latency. Protocol awareness and data retiming functions built into the retimer adds latency, up to 64 nanoseconds in Gen 4. The redriver's linear approach results in a very low latency solution, only about 100 picoseconds. In some applications, having the lower latency of a redriver may be most important. In others, the added performance of the retimer will be the only approach which can achieve a robust solution. As you can see, the retimer and redriver functions are two different approaches to solving the same problem. What we see here is a channel with 24 dB of attenuation at 8 GHz. This demonstrates how a signal degrades after it travels across a PCIe link. Due to significant channel loss, there is no eye opening in the remaining signal. Even with transmit equalization enabled, the inter-symbol interference due to attenuation has increased the jitter present enough to completely close the eye opening. This incoming signal is close to the PCIe Gen 4 limit in terms of channel losses. So even though the eye is completely closed, it is expected that a PCIe receiver would be able to correctly compensate for the attenuation and recover data from the incoming signal. Here we see what happens when a redriver is added to the PCIe link to help compensate for channel attenuation. As I mentioned before, the redriver compensates for high frequency losses in the transmission media, restoring horizontal and vertical eye opening in the received waveform. With this eye opening at the system receiver, we require only minimal additional equalization to completely optimize the eye opening, as well as recover the data with high margin. This leaves open the possibility to architect channels which have more loss and still recover the data with margin at the system PCIe RX. Here we use a shorter channel to demonstrate how the equalization looks to a PCIe system RX. Remember, the purpose of linear equalization is to make the effective channel appear shorter and less lossy to system PCIe receivers. This pair of oscilloscope waveforms shows linear equalization extending the channel by about 14 dB at 8 GHz. This extension would be invisible to the system receiver since the original waveform amplitude and wave shape characteristics are retained by the linear equalization function. Using the same plus 14 dB equalization function within a negative 40 dB channel would bring the high loss channel down to approximately negative 26 dB, which is within the PCIe Gen 4 specification. Now let's take a different look at the same two signals from the previous slide. In this case, the oscilloscope is used to identify and measure the random and deterministic jitter components. A comparison of the jitter with and without the redriver shows two important attributes of a high-quality linear equalization function. One, we see very low random jitter additions to the signal. In this case, it is plus 100 femtoseconds RMS. Two, you see very low deterministic jitter additions to the signal. In this case, it is plus 2 picoseconds. With this analog performance, the total margin reduction is only 3.4 picoseconds for a channel extension of 14 dB. This is just 0.05 UI on a Gen 4 signal. To refresh your mind on what we discussed, let's go over a short quiz. Check all correct statements. A. PCI Express is a serial bus protocol. B. PCI Express uses a 100 MHz clock to provide robust setup and hold time on the PCI data. C. PCI Express currently operates up to 16 gigabits per second. D. PCI Express never uses any signal conditioning components. The correct answer is A and C. Check all correct statements. A. PCI Express is a widely used standard in computers. B. Not all PCI Express channels will need signal conditioning. C. Linear equalization can be very effective extending the reach of a PCIe link. D. Protocol-aware retimer operation is defined by the PCIe 4.0 standard. The correct answers are A, B, C, and D. Finally, PCI Express repeaters using linear equalization have extremely low latency. Is it true, false, or unknown? The answer is true. Repeaters with linear equalization have a typical latency of only 100 picoseconds. This isn't much slower than the signal's propagation speed along the transmission line itself. In closing, I'm glad that we could offer you this segment on PCI Express. Watch for future sessions. We'll go into more details about the standard and the signal conditioning devices from Texas Instruments. Thanks.